गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, वेलकम टू द ई क्लास ऑफ डीपॉल स्कूल बारीपदा। गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन। चिल्ड्रेन, आई तापस सर टुडे गोइंग टू टीच स्टैंडर्ड 4 स्टूडेंट्स। Today's lesson, it is in science route. This lesson is very important for your exam point of view. So children, please watch this video attentively so that you can know more about this lesson. Let's see. Okay, today is lesson number 13. Today we are going to read, children. This lesson I have divided into two part. This one I am teaching the first part of this lesson. And let's see what is this lesson. This lesson is part one of safety rules and first aid. Today's lesson is safety rules and first aid. This is part one. Let's see the lesson, children. Accident may happen anywhere at any time. They occur mostly due to the carelessness or when we are in great hurry. Accidents are very common in cities. This is because there are a large number of vehicles like trucks, buses, cars, bicycle or cycle, etc. running in a city. A collision between two vehicles often lead to an accident. Accident generally happen on the road. It can be in village, in small town or in big cities. It doesn't matter. Where there is carelessness, there only the accident will take place. Accident most we see nowadays because due to number of vehicles. Nowadays every second person is having a vehicle and they don't know what are the traffic rules or how to ride the vehicle in a proper way on the road. They misuse the speed, they take it, the rules of the traffic rules as granted. Any but without going with the rules, they drive the vehicles and they cause accident. They not only get hurt but also they harm other also. So some of the safety rules are there to protect yourself and other while you are riding vehicles on the road. Here we will read. To avoid accident, we must follow the safety rules. On the road, we must walk along the footpath. If there is no footpath, walk close to the left side of the road. First safety rule is, while on walking on the road, always prefer to walk on the footpath. If there is no footpath on the road, generally in village area, we should go to the left side of the road and walk. It is the safest side to walk on. We must cross the road at the pedestrian crossing. Zebra crossing means if you want to cross the road, use the zebra crossing. Mostly we will find in cities. But if there is, if you are crossing on a small road, on a small, in a small town, we should see left, right and then left. Then only if there is no vehicle coming from both the side, we can cross the road. We must cross the road when there is a green signal. Okay, if there is signal light, nowadays every big or small town they are having signal lights. If there is signal light, please see the signal light and cross the road. In generally cities, we go through this process of watching the signal light. If there is signal light green, then only you can move forward. If it is red, stop and wait for the signal to be green. If it is yellow, means get ready, means any moment there will be a signal of green light, then you can move ahead. If there is no zebra crossing, we should look after right and left and cross. As I told you, if in small towns, if you go, there is no zebra crossing. Only cities we generally see zebra crossings. Small town, then what you have to do? You have to first you will look to the right side, then you look to the left side, Then again you look to the right side, then if you find there is no vehicle coming from both the side, then only you go or cross the road. If there is vehicle coming from both the side, if it is a busy road, then wait for the time when there is the road is empty, then only you should cross the road. Don't take it granted and think that let me run and cross the road. It can cause you a great problem. You can have a big accident if you do so. At home, what are the safety measures we should take? We should be very careful while lighting a stove. Sometimes big flame suddenly come out of the stove and cause accident. If you are at home, it doesn't mean that there will be no accident. Most of the accident takes place at home only. So if you are burning a stove or mummy is handling a gas, that time please go, don't go near to it. If you are handling the stove or gas, please take it very seriously, because any type of carelessness in the kitchen room can cause a big accident. We should always keep well away from the stove when food is being cooked. Steam escaping from a boiling pan can cause us bad burn. If something mummy is cooking in the kitchen room, please keep yourself away from that place. That is not the place for you to go, because the boiling thing or frying thing, the boiling water or the frying oil can split onto your body and you can have a bad burn. So please avoid going in the kitchen room. We should not play with match in the kitchen. Use no match stick. It looks that it is a small one stick. It cannot bring a lot of cannot bring any problem, but you don't know that one single stick can spoil the life of a person. If he is or she is careless while handling the match stick, it can burn the body, burn the house, everything in the house. So we should handle the match stick properly in the kitchen room. We must not switch on or switch off the electric appliances with wet hand. Don't use your wet hand to switch on or switch off the light, because electricity, water is a good conductor of electricity. Any wet hand or wet thing if you are touching and putting inside, putting onto the switch switch to put on or put off the light, there is a chance that you can have electric shock. Always wipe your hand with dry towels, then only use electric appliances. Next, electric, we should never run up or down the stair. If we trip, we may fall a long way down. We should not leave things on the floor. Sometimes it may be fall. Means while getting down from the staircase or going up to your upstairs with the staircase, using the staircase, always be careful to put the feet in the proper step. If your step will be here and there, you are disturbed, you are watching somewhere and you are putting your feet there, if there is chance that there you can have a fall, and if you fall from the staircase, you will go down and you will have your broken head or hand or leg. So please be careful while getting up and or coming down from the staircase. We should not leave thing on the floor. Someone might trip on fall. If generally we see at home children playing with toys and they keep the toys here and there, it is very harmful thing, because any senior person, elderly person who is or she is coming into the room, he or she has not seen the toys there, in or his or her feet fall on the toys, he can have a bad fall, and that old lady or old man can have a big problem by getting hurt if he or she fall from by the toys. So we should not take medicine of our own. Means medicine is very good thing for health, but without doctor's consent we should not take medicine. Especially at home, you children should take the help of your parents. If you want to have any type of medicine, please get consult with your parents. If they say yes, you can have that medicine, then only you can take. Don't take as granted that let me take the medicine, it is of it will have no problem. I know that this is that medicine which I want to eat. Please don't do like that. Please ask for your parents, especially your mummy or daddy, then only you have the medicine, because it can cause problem for you. On the playground, if you are on the playground also, you can have accident. We must not play rough games. Such game may cause accident like sprain and fracture. If you are pushing someone while playing, or if you have put your feet while he was running, you can put your feet before him, then he will also have a bad fall. If somebody is swinging on the swing, if you push him, this type of thing we generally see naughty children do in the field. They unknowingly or knowingly bringing problem to others. It sometimes have small injury, and sometimes you will bring a great problem for the person whom you have pushed. So he can have a sprain or a fracture on leg or on hand. On some playground there are glass pieces, nail and stones. We should not play on this such playgrounds. Means when you are selecting a field to play, you should watch that field is a nice field, means even field, filled with grasses, and there should not be any type of big stones or broken glass pieces. They can anytime harm you. We must not play near thorny hedge and barbed wires, means some of the place covered with the wires which are fully rusted due to rain and weather. Those wires we should not catch, or we should not play near them. Your rusted wire can bring accident. If you will have a cut from that rusted wire, you will have tetanus also. So please avoid these type of places where there is thorny bushes are there, or barbed wires are there. So please prefer a field which is free from all these things, a good field, a even field, and green field. There you play with your friends or your brothers and sisters. At school, most of us, the children stay half of the day in the school. It should be a place where we go to study. Sometimes we go for play also in the play period or game period. There, this type of incident happened that somebody is pushing or somebody is throwing stone to other, somebody is throwing knowingly stone, throwing the ball to other. This can cause any type of accident and bad heart. We should not run about or climb on the desk. At the school, inside the classroom, it is very bad habit to climb over the desk. It is very bad habit in the sense that we are keeping the books on the desk. Please don't stump there on the desk. And sometimes children, by doing so, they fall from the desk and have a bad heart. We should never shout into someone's ear. Means if your ear is a very soft place, you are having a very thin membrane ear, that is called ear. This membrane helps us to listen. Very soft one. You know, ear is having the smallest bone inside the ear. So it is having the smallest bone of our body is there in the ear. If you shout loudly, then there is a chance that child will have a problem in the ear for your shouting. Please don't shout anybody's ear loudly. This is also a very bad habit. We should not eat fruit and nuts from plant we do not know. Some are poisonous. They can make us ill. Some of the school, especially the government school, we find it is kept in the open place. There is some schools that don't have four walls. So there is no boundary, means it is open place. So children prefer to go out of the school campus and they eat here and there. If you are eating here and there nuts or strawberries from there, it is very serious thing, because you don't know, it can be a poisonous plant. This berry, which it looks beautiful, doesn't mean that it is good for health. You can have it and you will have problem. So please avoid this type of thing. You are going to read to the school, please read and write there. Please try to obey your parents' advice, and in the school try to obey your teacher's advice. Don't do such thing that can bring problem to you as well as other. First aid. First aid is the immediate treatment or help given to a person who is hurt or injured. Before a doctor comes, first aid helps the injured person to become comfortable, reduce his suffering, and may even save his life. First aid is the help given to the injured person before a doctor arrives. Generally, we people keep first aid box in our home, where bandage is there, Dettol is there, then your cotton is there, scissor is there, cream is there, burning cream, Burnol, or any type of cream, which if you have bruise, if you fall somewhere, you have bruise, you can use that cream. These type of things are there in that box. We generally keep in our home. Any type of incident, any type of small accident happened at home, we can do the first aid to the person. Then only we'll take that person to the doctor, because without doctor concern, we don't keep those injured person at home. It may, the doctor may give you some advice how to handle the wound. So first, the treatment you do at home, that is called first aid. Some general advice to the first aider means, if you give first aid to someone, these are the general advice you should have. Act quickly, this will help to save life. If you are seeing that somebody got hurt, your first duty is to provide first aid to that person. If you will take time, you will think whether I will do or not, if I will do, what will happen. This type of thinking can bring a big problem for the person who is got hurt. So try to stop people from crowding around the patient. If somebody fall from the bike or had a bad accident, he was falling on the ground, most of the people surround that injured person. By seeing their face, he got more nervous. He generally gets more nervous, and sometimes he faints also. It is better, please keep it open. Please let the air, fresh air to come to him, and always consult him that you don't worry, you are okay and nothing has happened. That will build confidence in that accident that person who is lying on the ground. He will have all type of confident, and he will surely recover from it. Second, someone for a doctor as soon as possible, or carry the patient to the nearest doctor. Then you take person to the nearest doctor, because without doctor consent, don't keep that person at home. Do not move the patient if it is likely that he has broken anyhow. If you find that by falling from the bike or had a bad accident, he broke his hand or leg, please don't drag him. Please keep him still and call the doctor. Let doctor check it, what is the condition of the bone, whether it is minor fracture or major. Be calm and methodical. If you handle a person having injured, handle him properly by saying good words to him. You make him calm and always and encourage him that everything is okay, everything is under control, you should not worry, you are fine. That will surely build a confidence in that person, and he will not feel that he is having a major problem. Always keep a first aid box handy. Always keep a first aid box at home. It is a very good thing to have at home. Every now and then we generally have small and big accident. That will surely help us before we take it the person to the doctor. While waiting for the doctor to come here, there are many things to you do. If there is injured person is conscious, suggest that he or she may lie down. You may cover the person with a sheet, blanket, coat, or may covering available at that time to keep him warm. If he or she can here try to keep him or her cheerful. Means if somebody is having an accident, if he is falling on the ground, most of the occasion they get senseless because of fear. Maybe they are not that much injured, but out of fear they get senseless. In that case, if somebody is having accident and he is very nervous, please try to cover him with a blanket, try to give him warm, try to console him, try to give him hot milk to drink, and tell him some good thing that about that his injury. He might not be knowing that he is how much injured, but you are seeing his injury, you can say that this is very minor injury, you should not fear about this. God is doctor is almost coming on the way, you don't worry, you will get the first aid from doctor, and keep yourself strong, don't let down, and that will build a strong confident within that person, and he will surely recover soon from that accident. This lesson is over, children. Now this is the first part of the lesson. Second part I will tell you in the second video. So I am sure this will help you to understand the lesson, the half of the lesson which I have taught in this video. Please watch it again and again. Very important lesson, safety, how to keep yourself safe from accident. These are the things which I have told in this video. Thank you for watching this video, children. God bless you. Have a good day. Bye-bye.